I mean, that's a really good question. There are a number of different routes that somebody could go. I mean, it's hard for me not to think specific in terms of like how content and creators kind of come to me. But I mean, and this is probably advice that's being given across the board, but I mean, the first thing is as much content as everybody here can self-produce and self-distribute, the better, because then you're just further getting your name out, you're getting your stories out, you are building up social followings. That's just going to benefit you. And if you can do it, I mean, you can either do it across platforms or you can kind of just focus on one so that you're kind of getting, you know, actually, that's a good question. I'd love to ask you, Kevin, as well, if you have a recommendation here, like, would it be better? In some ways, it's good to like just focus on one. Like if you say you just have like your YouTube, then you can direct everybody to your YouTube video, then that would mean that you'll get more hits and it'll be more impressive looking to people who are going to be viewing it than if you post the same exact video. It's like the opposite, I guess, of what you've been doing, Kevin, where you kind of want to pick your platform. If you're self-producing, self-distributing, pick your platform, whether it's YouTube, whether it's on Facebook, Instagram video, things like that, and try to channel all of your viewers through social media to that place. So then you're going to get the most bang for your buck in terms of how many views you have, because that view number can be something that can be very impressive. Another way to go about it is, I would say if there's a way to find a platform that is, you know, producing like a kind of a bigger platform that's producing short form and mid form content, like for example, like Group 9 Media, like one of our brands or something, you know, like a BuzzFeed or Bernie, you might even think of other places that might be good for this. And if there's a way for you to kind of get your content across to them and for them to then either amplify it or if they're impressed by it, help you to fund further episodes of it. That's another way that you can go about, again, getting your web series funded.
Yeah, no, Louie, I think you're right on the heavying up on a platform. I think even in what we do start somewhere. So like, if we're starting on Twitch, we are optimizing, to use crappy corporate words, like we're optimizing for Twitch. That's the first priority. We have to be successful where we start. We have a show on YouTube we do with Coleman Domingo, who's on one of our shows, Fear the Walking Dead. It's like a cocktail show with him. It is built for YouTube. We are looking to build the audiences there. We have a show with Amanda Knox, a true crime show that is built for Facebook Watch. It's made to connect to communities there. Now, we expect those all to continue to have this kind of long tail of international licensing and life on other media when cut down in different ways. But it's a great point that, like, pick a place and go in there. I think with us, there's a couple, because we're also a group of traditional TV networks and SVOD channels, there's a couple other ways that we're looking at short form and short form creators. One is like, yes, we are looking for creators and shows that have followings, because just like everybody else, we're chasing views and fan bases. And I think that we are in a transition phase between where we were exclusively looking for outside talent to insert into the existing IP and worlds that we have, to now where we are creating original IP that just lives in the digital space. So finding properties that can just live where they are. They don't need to be, we don't have to take a great voice and then have them go write a Walking Dead webisode series or do a docuseries based around Breaking Bad. We can take some original IP, and if we think it fits, we can just use it as is or expand it as is. So in that way, finding somebody who has a voice and has a following, that's key. But I think that what I just mentioned, the idea that we are also a collection of existing platforms that are hungry for voices, means that all this stuff also is still sort of that traditional kind of calling card content to connect with showrunners, connect with our internal development people at places like Shudder and Acorn and Sundance TV and Sundance Now, who are all, you know, really hungry to find some new voices. And I think The other thing I'll say, and this actually connects back to your question about sort of format and what people are doing right now, what the future looks like. You know, I think the world we're in, this COVID world, even if we had a even if we had a vaccine tomorrow, it's going to have lasting changes to the kinds of things we're watching for a good long time. And that means a lot of the formats that are organic to digital spaces are going to start to bleed out and be relevant in linear and SVOD and Netflix and everywhere else where you wouldn't normally see that kind of content thrive. I think it will. So like, I think one thing that you've probably heard this, Bernie, from Twitch is one thing they said to us as we were standing up our channel there was that, you know, Twitch in quarantine kind of looks a lot like Twitch not in quarantine. So like in some ways they were already that the platform that was ready. And therefore, and in some ways the world came to them through unfortunate circumstances, but I think that's going to be lasting. So I think there's more routes open for digital native creators off digital now because of the world we're in.